Hey folks, Dagan here from PMTVUK, and I know I say this a lot in some videos, but this is the most exciting product I've demoed in a very, very long time because I love it and I've been using it for an extended period of time and it puts a smile on my face every time I play it. This is the Blackstar Amped 1, and it's the most exciting thing to happen to the guitar pedal board in a long time. Everything you're hearing is coming from this little box. I've used this so much that I now associate my tone, the guitar I hear in my head, with a Blackstar Amped 1. It's a little box of joy. It's a power amp, essentially, with a preamp built in. It gives you some fantastic tones. It's very versatile. It does a lot. Let's get into it. But first, I want to play some more D chords because it sounds mint. It's very touch responsive. Very, very touch responsive. Right. So in a nutshell, this is a 100 watt little power amp that you can use independently. You can get your tone from this, or you can use it as a flat response power amp. Use it with some pedals that you might enjoy, like the Freeman BEOD, all the fun little amp in a box pedals like that, and run that into this. Either have it running out into the speaker, like I've got right now, like a PA speaker or a flat response speaker, using the cab rig software inside, or run it actually out into a speaker cabinet. Why did I say like a speaker cabinet? You run it into a speaker cabinet. So this is everything you need in an amplifier, but tiny, fits in your hands or on a pedal board. It's mint. So I'll talk about the different ways in which you can use it in a second, but the way I've been using it is just at the end of my pedal board. So I have all my traditional pedals and I'd usually run into an amplifier on stage and mic up said amplifier. I run everything into this and have this at the end of the chin as if it is an amplifier and XLR out into either a recording software. You can do so much more with recording, which again, I'll touch on in a second, or in a PA system or whatever you want to do. Or like I say, if you want to run it into a cab, you can run it into a cab. Not only that, there is an effects loop built in, so you can run all your time-based or modulation effects, whatever you want, in this as if it was an effects loop on an actual amplifier. It's bloody magnificent. I've got it set up right now. It's a nice distorted tone. 100 watts, 100 watts, and it's this big, and it weighs absolutely not, it's substantial, it weighs substantial. It's not like a cheap plastic thing, it's substantial weight, but it's lighter than you think. For a 100 watt amplifier, you can fit on your pedal board. Run it down to 20 watts though, or 1 watt, depending on the situation in which you're using the Amped 1, or how much headroom and squishiness you want. Because when you turn up a traditional valve amplifier, 20 watts, it sounds different the louder it gets. Same as 100 watts. So it's all personal preference, really. So 100 watts, 20 watts, or 1 watt. Like I said, I've got on the UK setting right now. There's three voicings in the Amped 1, UK, USA, or flat. Like a flat response straight through, no kind of preamp voicing on the go. UK is based off an old school 60s British amplifier, if you couldn't tell, with that lovely focused mid. There's a USA voicing, which is based off also an old school American amplifier from back in the day. That has a bit less grit. So this is the gain 3/4 of the way up so I can get that gnarly UK tone. USA. Especially nice with a neck pickup. So those are the two main voicings, but you can mess with them thanks to the response control down here. Now the response control gives you different power amp valves, kind of, like make-believe valves to give you a different kind of touch response, different kind of natural compression. Because when you play different amplifiers that have different valves in, like KT88s, 6L6s, which are more American clean amp based, EL34s, which are that British kind of tone, they've all got their own unique kind of characteristics and feel to them. You can mess with them in this, so you can have a UK style amplifier with KT88s or 6L6s, whatever you want, and I'm going to go through those tones shortly, but that's what that response does down there. You'll notice a linear at the bottom as well, so linear is kind of linear, it's straight through, perfect for amp modelers, or if you've got a Line 6 Helix or a quad cortex or something and you want to hear that on stage with an amplifier, run it linear with the flat voicing straight into a speaker cab and you will get that tone live on stage. Because people have mixed opinions about flat response speakers because there's so many out there these days. With this, you get the actual power amp and get that true tone from your modeler live on stage. It does so much. Because it's Blackstar, they've made it super easy to use as well. There's no crazy features and stuff that can melt your mind as soon as you plug it in. It's plug in and play it, and you'll get a great sound out the box. You can delve into it deeper with Blackstar's Architect software, because there is a USB-C up top, which it comes with. You can plug into the Architect software and not only use this as a plug-in, get the tones from this directly through that USB, you can also use the Architect software to really tweak the tone to what you want. But if that's not your jam, bass, middle, treble does it for me. They're very responsive and, well, they do what they say on the tin. When you're in the linear mode, though, bass and treble work as a cut or boost. So when they're halfway up, you either boost or cut those frequencies on linear. But the rest of the time, it just works as a traditional amplifier. That's so good. As you can see down here, there's a reverb switch. There's built-in reverb. And the reverb is very sweet. Out the box, one control to control how much reverb you want, but again, if you plug it in and mess with the Architect software from Blackstar, you can change the reverb from hole, spring, and plate, adjust the decay and the depth and the tone, all that kind of stuff if you want to plug it in and mess with it a bit more. But out the box, man. Just great. And the reverb control has a freeze feature, which I don't know how I can do it with one hand, but when you hold it down, it freezes and repeats that reverb and kind of makes it sound really ethereal, like a soundscape, but allows you to play over the top of it as well and add to it. So kind of, when you let go, it goes away. Hopefully that came across okay, you get the gist. To the bottom right, you will notice a preset switch, and that also does what it says. That activates a preset which you pre-saved within the AMPED-1. And the way I use this, I've got it back on the UK setting for my regular drive tone. I've got my clean tone saved on the preset. So when it's in preset mode, you save a preset by holding it down for a few seconds. You'll see it flash, and that then indicates that what's on here has been saved in the preset. I've got that set up as a clean tone, live sort, and switch between as if it was a regular amplifier. None of this does anything when it's in the preset mode. The light's off, back to regular mode where you can change the sound and kind of mess with it on the fly. You'll notice there in the presets, not only can you change the voicings, you change the EQ, obviously you can add or take away reverb. You can also change the VAR response as well. So have your own unique preset within this, so there's two tones in one. Two classic amplifiers in one little box. Thank you, Blackstar. So that's what you can see from the top when you look directly at your brand new AMPED-1. I assume you've already bought one because it's mint. So I'm saying your AMPED-1. Let's talk about what else it can do, the other awesome features. First off, the way I'm running it right now. So I got the XLR, like I said, out into a PA speaker in front of me, giving me the sound I hear live every weekend. But also practicing, if I want to put it into an interface, a DAW, that's the tone that I'm now accustomed to, and it's mint. This features Blackstar's Carbrig software. which is awfully fancy. There's 250 combinations. You can have different amplifiers, sizes, speakers, microphones, 250 combinations. You can have them on axis, off axis. This is kind of the next level of impulse responses. It's way much more than downloading IRs. You can go so much more in depth with the CabRig software. So you can obviously manipulate all that with the CabRig stuff by USBing it into your computer and having a bit of fun that way. You can save three presets of cabs into the CabRig, so you can kind of move it on the fly as well. Little switch on the side that goes from the cabs. Let me show you the cabs that come over from the factory. This is the second one. My personal favorite. There's also a little level control on the side here if you don't want to touch this massive volume. You've got the master set to like, you, so it's nice under your fingers because everything reacts with each other, like the response and that. If you want to mess with the level a bit more, there's a level control on the side as well. So the cabs. Cab 2, my favorite. Cab 1. Back to cab 2. Cab 3. So out the box, there's three tones from Blackstar, but you can manipulate and change any of them you want and choose any three of them once you've got it set up with the Blackstar CabRig software, if you so choose. Up at the top of the Amped 1, you'll find a big old regular IEC power cable thing. So it's not what you get on some other products like this, where it's like a transformer, like the kind of ones you get on laptops. This is a regular amp power supply, which is a great little feature. Guitar input up here, and there's a MIDI in on the far left. So this is a MIDI mini jack converted to a MIDI cable, which it comes with. It comes with this little adapter. Use a high quality MIDI cable and MIDI into your software so you can control things via MIDI or a MIDI clock live, change the presets, change the responses, anything your heart desires, all via MIDI with the Amped 1. They've really thought of everything with this pedal slash amplifier as well. There's two power outputs with a total output of 500 milliamps. So you can have two pedals running alongside this as well, like a delay or an overdrive, have everything on one little board, and you don't need a separate power supply. If you've got two extra pedals you want to use with your Amped 1 by Blackstar, there's power supplies up top. So thank you, Blackstar, for that as well. To the right-hand side of the guitar input, you'll notice the effects loop as well, but it's only one output. It comes with a TRS Y cable, so it splits out into two different female outputs, so then you can run a traditional effects loop into one input slash output on the back. Really, really nifty bit of kit. And below that, you'll find the speaker output, 16 ohm and 8 ohm. Only run one into a 16 ohm cabinet or 4 ohm cabinet, but yeah, that's how you connect it to a speaker cabinet. USB on top as well, like I said before, for the Architect software if you want to delve deep, and the CabRig software. I think that's it. It looks really pretty. There's a light up star on it. I think it's mint. I'm in love with it. If I hadn't made that clear. So, let's have some fun now. I'll use my Kramer Pacer first, then you'll hear some sounds with a Strat with some single coils. I'm using Klotz cables into a PA speaker, and yeah, let's play with a gain on the UK tone first. I'll play with some of the responses as well. So the amplifier this is based off, old black and gold one, is typically associated with EL34 valves or tubes if you're American, and that's what I've got on right now. But if you want to mess with that to get a different kind of response, different compression, different kind of boldness, changing keys fine as well, just letting you know that off the bat. Let's give you a little rundown of these responses. So KT88, you'll find on a lot of American higher gain amplifiers, have got a nice kind of compression and tightness to them. 6L6s, these are the kind of things you'll find in a lot of American amplifiers, like Fenders and stuff. 6L6s, a beautiful kind of chimey, scooped almost, mid-range, wonderful. EL34, classic Marshall kind of grit, pokey mid-range. 6V6s, you'll find them in a lot of smaller combos, like American Cleat Amp small combos and stuff, a very, again, kind of tight sound. A lot of terms are getting repeated here, but you don't hear with words, you hear with your ears, if that also makes sense. And EL84s, which is the Vox chiminess. That's me turning down the gain to give you a bit more clarity. But like I was saying at the start, when you use the volume on your guitar, or even change your pick attack, it's very responsive and it reacts like a proper old school valve amp. Let's crank it again to see what it sounds like now, because I haven't actually done that with it. Let's go KT88. You're going to hear it with an overdrive pedal in a second to really hear it shine with a bit of extra grit, but that's all the gain has gotten it for now. So that's the UK tones. Breaks up when you turn the gain up. When you go to the US, there's a lot less breakup, but there's a lot of headroom on the US, especially in neck pickup tones. The gain down for an idea as well. You can't get a bad sound out of it at all. So that's on the KT88. If you go to 6L6s, again, that traditional. EL84s. Six V6s. A bit boxier for that, isn't it? Thirty-fours? And just because we're here, let me show you what the flat voice sounds like with the linear. So this is just straight up through, as if you wanted to get all your tones and impulse responses from something like a Line 6 Helix or a Head Rush or a quad cortex thing. Another reverb is still on as well, turn that off. Just straight up the sound of this guitar. And you will get the purest tone without any effect from the AMPED-1 if you just want to power it into a cab or out of a DI or something with a bit of extra special seasoning from your amp modeler or multi-effects. Thank you. this obviously now has a Boss DD8 in the effects loop. And it works like a regular effects loop, so it doesn't get affected by any of the preamp. It goes between the preamp and the power amp as it would in a traditional amplifier. And also this is, what single coils sound like with the Blackstar Department 10 Amp 1. We're on the USA setting with some 6L6s. Let's go down to EL34s. You can feel the headroom under your fingers. You can feel there's so much more to it. So if you were to rock pedals in front of it, it would just lap them up. Just so happens, like Blue Peter, I've got it right now. Again, one of my favorite overdrive pedals, being powered from the Amped 1. This is the Department 10 dual drive. Two channels with a lovely Blackstar drive with a tube in it. Bit of crunch. Loves a bit of pedals, does the Department 10. You can even set this up so the preset didn't go to a clean channel or whatever you want. You could set up more reverb and a volume boost to give you more of a, well, to get a lead tone. Why am I showing you the Department 10 dual drive, which is great, but I should be showing you this on the UK. So if you wanted to rock it that way, set up a regular distortion tone, like what I've got right here. I'll turn the reverb down a bit. That could be your main tone. Instead of setting it up to be a clean channel on the preset, it's so responsive. Like I said, just turn the volume down when you want to go clean. Preset, which will turn up the reverb. You might change the tube to be a bit more focused. Click on an extra overdrive pedal to get even more kind of. Or no reverb if you want to take it to the next level and have the gain on the Amped 1. If you're in a metal band, that doesn't really cut from metal. Put an overdrive in front of it. Let's add some delay to really end this video with a bang. Bloody love this thing. Let me know what you think about it down below in the comments. Like I say, it's one of the greatest things to happen to the guitar world since the invention of the string. Let me know what you think about this down below. And yeah, if you like this video, give it a thumbs up and subscribe to PMTVUK here on YouTube for lots more cool guitar and music related content. If you want any more information on the Blackstar Department 10 Amped 1 or any Blackstar product for that matter, click the link in the description box down below and it'll take you to pmtonline.co.uk. We are playing music today on Facebook, Instagram, Twitter and TikTok. Give us a like and a follow to see pictures of this with nice filters on. I've been Dagan, I'll see you next time.